Beer Gockles reviews with me, Terry K. Lambics. Now, it's funny old kind of funny old brewery sort of not brewery, some funny old fermentation stuff going on with lambics, and it's mainly down to kind of natural brewing, and you've got you know, well, you've got Brettanomyces lambicus, and you've got all sorts of different, you've got kind of a fight between microorganisms that becomes interbalanced and that, and as with things like cheese, you get certain blue cheeses and things like that, you get microorganisms doing certain things. Now, even in a cheese that you've already got as a cheese, you get certain, say blue cheeses and that, you know, you get a certain, say a Stilton or something like that. Get it warmed up, let it like breathe, let it warm up, let it kind of have its time in a kind of tepid environment, and suddenly things start to happen. Like a blue cheese and that. You get things happening amongst the mould and things. They start getting slightly sweaty and sweet, and all of a sudden these little bacterias come into action as well. And you've got moulds and bacterias are having a fight over the same region, which is where penicillin originally come from. You know, penicillin won the fight against the bacterias. You know, anywhere there was penicillin mould, bacteria's went, okay, you have it, you win. And that's where the kind of penicillin come from, the pill, the tablet, you know. But you got that sort of thing going on massively in things like lambic. And it's a nature's miracle. And there's a lot of things going on with it, but I've got to curb myself. I've got to pull myself in, because I don't know what the relationship between lambic and other, you know, and raunchy stuff is. I worded that very carefully, but kind of raunchy stuff and brewing and fermentation and whatever else, but. It always kind of reminds me of kind of a more earthy stuff, things of a more earthy nature. And I'm not talking about aromas, I'm talking about something, a sensation from the smells. When you get a smell and you get, and the taste, and this, suddenly I'm like, I mean, it wakes up a certain animal. I mean, even now, I'm like, this year is like under breaking strain. As I'm squeezing it, you know. I ain't got the top off yet, but I know what's to come, you know. Yeah, literally. Now, straight away, the kind of physical aromas that you get, a bitter and now I've got to try and split my head now, because one half's going, and I've got to get on to just on the base smells, taste, and not the stuff that's primordial stuff, you know, is going on inside you, going, yeah, right, you know, sort of growly, and stop it, right. Getting bitter apples almost. Horse blankets. Sorry. I'm really sorry. Everyone that smells a lambic, they go, oh yes, all saddles, horse blankets. And you think, and you, and I say, no, I know I say this in everyone, but how many people have smelt horse blankets and all, you know, all that all saddles and things. Maybe it comes from the aromas of all kind of hormones and stuff like that going on. But I'm sinking back into base stuff. I just get base instincts come out. Right, things that ain't base instincts are straight away into apple cores. Of course, it's not hard to work against this. It's like a salmon trying to swim upstream. Got all the base instincts coming. Oh. And I've got to give a review against that. Getting a slight creamy note, kind of a slight lactose background, but without being sweet, and very funnily. Is funnily, is that a word? Strangely. Oh, Jesus. It smells glorious, but for all the wrong reasons. Getting grapey notes there as well. There's not a lot of kind of the traditional brewing background kind of smells. There's not a lot of traditional brewing yeast going on. There's not the traditional brewing like barley sort of malty smells going on. It's right. Enough of the smells. I'm going to have to dive in. Let's pour it and see what we get. I'm pouring a lot in, yeast and all, if there's any, which I don't think there is. Carbonated, it's doing its thing. Blimey. Look, I've got to say, there's something very sexual about lambic. And if you're not getting that, then you've not had a lot of sex. Sorry. I'm going completely off. Right. Right. As I said, apple cores, apple. You're getting bits of tiny little edges of chives and things like that. It's so hard. Strange little notes. A kind of almost a musty, cardboardy note, but not in a nasty way. And that is unbelievable to say that. Damp sort of smells, but you're getting a lot of grape. Right, I'm going in. Chin chin. Cheers. Bottoms up. Cheers. Bottoms up. Cheers. God, Christ. That's a lambic. That's really fruity. This is. It's had stuff added, surely. Ingredients, what's that say? You got any in English? No. Right, let's have a look on there. I can't hardly see it. Ingredients. Don't think we can see anything there. Let me know, guys, if you see anything else. But it tastes apple-y. It tastes really apple-y. It tastes a bit grapey. Really apple-y. It tastes really fruity. It doesn't taste like a proper lambic. It smells like a proper lambic because it's got them animal sort of things. Kind of bring the demon out in you. Proper bring the demon out. But it's got that kind of, that, you know, that kind of fruity sort of thing. You know, you get a lambic, you add your fruits into it, and for the wussies, it's all nice, but it's not what I call beer, really. This is cool, but you know, as soon as you add fruits and things, it's nice, but it ain't kind of what I call proper beer, you know. And lambic is about as beer as they come, but this is very fruity. Very nice though, really nice. Really, really nice, but very, very fruity, very grapey, very apple-y. I'd be interested actually to take one of these down to a wine connoisseur of mine, a friend of mine, Jason Cotsey, from Cotsey and Boffa. Proper wine connoisseur who you can have a chat with, you know, I think sometimes wine connoisseur and religion is in a similar, and beer sometimes even is in a similar realm, that you can't chat to people sometimes that are from that world. You know, you talk to them, they're like, you know, that sort of thing. And they suddenly, it just won't split on a decision, or you know, or kind of go, well, you know, things, you know, like Jason tasted one of these. Where was it? He tasted one of these chaps and said it was one of the most complex things he'd ever tried and everything else, and he was really impressed because he's talking out the back of my head, because he's a big wine guy on it. Now, he's had some absolute superb wines, but he was really impressed with that. And rather than say, no, I'd rather have a wine, he went, wow, that is impressive. I think he would be impressed with that, because it's very winey, very vinous in that, you know, it is winey, but at the same time, it's apple-y. Oh, that's quite nice. Tastes like a cider, mixed with a wine, mixed with a lambic. And you've got that lambic animal quality. It's like having a good kind of nice sweet cider, a semi-dry wine, and then mixing all those animal musks and things from a good lambic. That is, I'm in two minds. One of me is singing and dancing for joy, and I really love that. And the other side is going, it's too fruity. It's kind of too, it's like, for me, mustard is English, Coleman's English mustard. Give you a nosebleed when you put a little bit on your tongue in it, you know. It's not French mustard. French mustard is a sauce, you know. It's nice enough, but it's a sauce. This is kind of like your French mustard. It's like, I wouldn't describe it as mustard. The same as I wouldn't really describe it as lambic, but then I would describe it as really, really beautiful. I'm going to have to try my mate Jason out on it. It really is beautiful, and it's quite vinous and winous and venous and vinous. That there, Faro, Lambic, Lindemans. I've got to say, I'm in two minds, but I think you guys, especially if this is your introduction to Lambics, definitely try it, buy it, and like it. Without a doubt, try and buy it and love it. I kind of think I almost love it. I really do. I almost love it, but it's just throwing me in too many directions at once. And one of them's fruity and all that. And it's like, hold on, lambic ain't fruity. So there you go. But it's very fruity. Cheers. Bottoms up. Chin chin. lovely. Love it. With a man to the brain, with a man.